Provision for liquidated damages also at the rate of 0.05% of the contract price per day, subject to a limit of 10% maximum, has been made in case there is delay on part of the contractor. Thus, EPC document balances the duties and responsibilities of the government as well as the contractor. As you all are aware, that India has a very large road network of over 3.34 million kilometers, comprising of around 82,000 kilometers length of national highways, 130,000 kilometers state highways, 3.14 millions of major district road, rural road and urban road. Road infrastructure contributes not only to the economic growth of the nation but also help the poverty alleviation and generation of employment. It is necessary for the highway engineers as well as contractors to provide world-class roads to our citizens, facilitating their access to education, health and well-being within the context of sustainable development. UPA government has given a thrust to all the areas of infrastructures in the country. The government has made substantial efforts to tackle the shortcomings of highway sectors and to reform its transport institutions. Proper implementation of various road projects is the most important aspect. This requires higher professional ethics and commitment to ensure that roads constructed at such high cost are long-lasting and do not deteriorate prematurely. There are national assets, and they should be managed like other assets, so that we get good quality roads, and they need to be maintained efficiently with proper strategy and planning. We should consider proactive approach in maintenance instead of attending to very badly damaged roads by way of crisis management, as is the case so far. I, on this occasion, make an earnest appeal to the entire highway engineers gathered here, including representatives of contractors, consultants, concessioners, engineers from state PWDs, and other departments, to take a pledge in not compromising on the quality of construction besides completing the road projects without time and cost overrun. Such a commitment will go a long way in providing durable roads, conserving scarce material like aggregates, sand and earth, etc. I would like to highlight the achievement of my ministry in the development of national highways in the state of Andhra Pradesh. National Highway Authority of India has undertaken projects in various phases of NHDP, Phase 1 GQ, and entire 785 kilometers under Phase 2 Nagpur-Hyderabad section is completed. Port connectivity of 12 kilometers, Visakhapatnam port to NH5, is also completed. 335 kilometers out of 526 kilometers road length under Phase 3 is completed, and balance 191 kilometers is under progress. Further, about 300 kilometers out of 1024 kilometers for the 6-laning under Phase 5 is under progress, and balance 724 kilometers is under implementation. 990 kilometers for 2-lane with paved shoulders under NHDP Phase 4 have been planned. I would like to take this opportunity and request the state government of Andhra Pradesh to kindly provide their full support in expediting the completion of these projects. In addition to above, my ministry has incurred about 280 crores for development of national highways in Andhra Pradesh during 2012 and 13. Further, 243 crore under left-wing extremism works and 242 crores have been spent in Andhra Pradesh on centrally sponsored schemes of CRF, Central Road Fund. Economic importance and interstate connectivity put together. Thus, a total of 765 crores has been spent during 2012-13 by my ministry for betterment and upkeep of national highways and other roads in the state of Andhra Pradesh. I also want to place on record that my efforts will continue to provide more funds for the state of Andhra Pradesh for the benefit of the general public. With the blessings of UPA Chairperson, Srimati Sonia Gandhi Ji, Honorable Prime Minister Dr. Manmohan Singh Ji, Sri Rahul Gandhi Ji, Honorable Minister for Road Transport and Highways Dr. C.P. Joshi Ji, kind support of Honorable Chief Minister Sri Kiran Kumar Reddy Ji, and sustained hard work of my officials, 1817 kilometers of new roads have been notified as new national highways on 22nd March 2013 by Gazette of India notification numbers 814E and 815E, and in September 2012 in the state of Andhra Pradesh.